Okay, hello friends. Today we are going to solve sheet 7 recursive, and it is very important. Okay, so we'll try to solve sheet 7, and I'll take a very basic question like Fibonacci. This is a very familiar question to everybody. So when you solve recursion, okay, when you try to solve recursion, you need two things. Okay. You need two things. First, you need base case where your function should be stopped. Okay, where your function should be stopped. Okay, so you need base case. Okay, base condition. And the second is recursive equations. Second is recursive equations or recurrence relation. In Fibonacci, this is called recurrence relation. This is called the second, the recurrence relation you will call it. This is two things we'll call is base case. Okay. So two things we need always when you try to solve recursion. So let's try to solve recursion. Okay, I actually solve it in this here. We'll explain it everything. Okay, so this is my base case. Okay, if n equal 1, if n equal to 2, this is my base case. And what we actually observe, this is a base case, you can check it. If n equal to 1, you should return 0. If n equal to 2, you should return 1. So let's try to understand how they actually calling each and every function. Okay, in each every recursive equation, you need to know recursive actually stored in call stack. Okay, so let's try to understand how it call it. Let n equal to 5. Okay, so understand n equal to 5. Okay, now this is a recursive equation, n equal to 5, and understand here, this is understand if it's f of 5. Okay, f of 5 will call f of 4, n minus 1 will be called before. Okay, if n minus 2 will write before it, so first we'll call f of n minus 3. Okay, so f of 4 will call first because n minus 1, again it will go above and say that is 4 equal equal 1, 4 equal equal 2, no. So it will call f of 3. Okay, again it call f of hit not call f of 2, 3 minus 1 2, and f of 2 n equal equal 2 is written 1. Okay, now it will go here, f of 3 will go here, and f in return it call f of 1, and n equal equal 1 is written 0. So 1 plus 0 become 1, so it return 1, and f of 4 will call f of 2 again. And you know that if n equal equal 2, it return 1, so f of 4 will become 1 plus 1 equal 2, it return 2. So f of 5 will actually left f of n minus 2, so f of 5 will call f of 3. Okay, here you can see that f of 3 actually we have actually cover it from this path. Okay, but we have computed again and again, and this is a overlapping sub problem are there, and we actually we will see that how to memoize this and how to store this, so we will not compute again and again. This is called dynamic programming. We will definitely do after this recursion. So f of 3 will call f of 2, and it return 1, and it call f of 1, it return 0. So 1 plus 0 1, it return 1, and here it will return 2. 2 plus 1, it return 3. So our answer is 3. So this is a tree path. Okay, so return 3. So let's try to submit it, and we'll okay, so this is a solution. And let's submit the code. Problem O. This is accepted. Okay, code is accepted, and let's try to solve another problem. Okay, so the maximum pass sum are there. Okay, this is a good problem, we can try it. Okay, so problem is that given a matrix A of size n comma n into m, then the maximum sum of number that can be obtained when you make, you know, take a path from A 1 to 1 to nm. If you stay aij, you can go only go to ai plus 1 j if and only if I less than equal to n, and only if j less than equal to m. Solve this problem using recursion. Okay, okay, now let's to understand if this is the path are there. Okay, and I have to maximum sum. Okay, so I can move here, I can move, I can move here, I can move here. Okay, I have two possibility. Okay, understand first it. I just want to go from this point to this point. What is my possibility? Like I only move here to here. Okay, and if I really want to find like this one, if I really want to find how to reach here, so just we'll go here to here. So what is our base case is, our base case is when I equal to 0 or I equal to 0 or j equal 0. That means it's the first row and first column, first row and first column. This is our base case. If I equal to 0 and I equal to 1, this is the OR operator. Okay, okay, so we have to make a prefix sum. Okay, like we have to make a sum of each and every like prefix sum like that. Okay, because this is my base case. Okay, because that like here 5, so this array will become 5, the first I equal 0, 5, 7, 7 plus 4, 11. This is my I equal to 0, and j equal to 0, 5 plus 1 becomes 6, and 6 plus 9 become 15. Okay, so this is my base case. If I equal to 0, j equal to 0, then after that we'll do this recursive equation ai plus 1 j comma j. So for this point, I have to create maximum. Okay, so my way to, I can come from here to come to here. Okay, there are two paths are there, so I definitely try to reach here with maximum point. Like here is 7 are there, here 6 are there, so I definitely take max 6 comma 7 plus whatever the value are there here, like 3. So our point will become 5, 7, 11, 6, 9, 15, and it will become 6 comma 7 is equal to 10. 7 plus 3, 10. So similar, like 10 comma 15, with definitely 15 is bigger than, so 15 plus 2 is 17. And similar, like 10 comma 11, 10 is bigger than, 10 is maximum, or 11 is maximum, so definitely I'll try to reach here through 11. So 11 plus 5 will become 16, and 16 comma 7, so definitely 17 is the maximum. 17 plus 7 will become 24. So from point 2 till point, our 24 is the maximum answer, and this is the answer. So let's you'll try this approach. Okay, you can try this approach. Just find a prefix array of this one, prefix sum. We just find this sum. Okay, first row and first column, and then just update the value with maximum. Okay, just it. I will not actually posting the solution. You will try to submit the solution, and you can comment on your submission in YouTube video. Okay, in this YouTube video you comment on your submission, definitely I'll check it. Okay, you submit it. Okay, thank you, Anna.